Hello everyone and welcome to today's video. We have some alarming news to share with you. Your eyes, or perhaps your children's or grandchildren's eyes, could be in danger. Let's explain. Did you know that myopia is becoming a silent pandemic? In less than 30 years, more than half of the world's population could be wearing glasses for distance vision. In the United States alone, millions of children already suffer from this condition. Just look around next time you're out. How many young children do you see wearing glasses? If you're a bit older, think back. Do you remember seeing so many children needing visual correction when you were young? And it's only going to get worse. By 2050, it's estimated that 1 in 2 Americans will need visual correction for myopia. In today's video, we're going to reveal the alarming reasons behind this explosion of myopia cases. What risks myopia poses to your vision, how this might affect you and your family, and most importantly, how you can protect your vision and that of your loved ones naturally. Oh, and you'll also take a quick test to see if you might have myopia. Stay until the end to discover natural strategies that could save your eyes in this digital world. But before we dive in, please like this video and help us break the record for likes. Show YouTube that this video is important for everyone's health and tell us in the comments, do you have myopia? Do you have children or grandchildren who do? What part of the country or world are you from? Let's get the conversation started. Now let's begin with some startling statistics. Did you know that nearly 30% of American children between 5 and 17 years old have myopia? That's about 14 million children struggling with this problem. And this is just the beginning of a growing wave. But what exactly is myopia? Myopia, also known as nearsightedness, is when you can't see distant objects clearly. Your eyes can't focus correctly, resulting in blurry vision for things that are far away. To understand why this is happening, let's take a look at the structure of the eye. Imagine your eye as a complex camera. When light enters, it passes through the cornea, the transparent outer layer. Then it travels through the pupil and the lens, which help focus the light onto the retina, a layer of tissue at the back of the eye. The retina sends signals to the brain through the optic nerve, allowing you to see. However, in myopia, the eyeball becomes elongated, causing light to focus in front of the retina instead of directly on it. The result? Distant objects appear blurry. Interesting and easy to understand, right? You've just learned something important about your eyes. But why is this happening more frequently? There are several theories to explain this phenomenon. Let's explore the three main ones: the near work theory, the DNA theory, and the outdoor exposure theory. First, the near work theory. When you spend a lot of time focusing on close objects, reading a book, a magazine, or using smartphones, tablets, or computers, there's continuous strain on your eyes. Focusing on something nearby makes our eye muscles work constantly. This constant effort can lead to elongation of the eyeball, which, as you've learned, leads to myopia. During the pandemic, this problem intensified, with children spending even more time in front of screens for online classes, and adults with remote work. Now pause for a moment and think, how much time do you spend using your phone, computer, or TV every day? Do you have any idea? A meta-analysis in 2015 indicated that for every additional hour of near work per week, the risk of developing myopia increases by 2%. That's quite significant, isn't it? The second theory is the DNA theory. Genetics also plays a crucial role. If your parents have myopia, you have a higher probability of developing the condition. Studies show a strong correlation between parents and children's myopia. Now, this is something we can't change, but it's important to be aware of. The third theory is the outdoor exposure theory. This theory suggests that exposure to natural light can help prevent myopia. Daylight stimulates the production of dopamine in the retina, which helps regulate eye growth. Children who spend more time outdoors have lower rates of myopia. Do you remember when we used to spend more time outdoors? Playing ball, riding bikes, and engaging in other outdoor activities. Today, children's football game is often FIFA on a gaming console. Being outdoors allows our eyes to focus on objects at different distances, which can help reduce strain on our eye muscles. Research conducted in Australia and Taiwan shows that children who spend more time outdoors have lower rates of myopia. A 2007 study in California also concluded that outdoor exposure significantly reduces the risk of developing myopia. Now, are you worried? Do you spend a lot of time indoors, barely seeing sunlight, living in front of screens, phone, tablet, computer? Do you have a genetic predisposition? Could you have myopia? Let's do a quick test to check. This simple test can be done at home, and you can also do it with your children or grandchildren. All you need is a well-lit environment and an object to focus on. Step 1. Choose a distant object. Find an object about 20 feet, 6 meters away. It could be a wall with a picture, a tree outside, or something similar. Step 2. Cover one eye. Cover one eye with the palm of your hand and try to focus on the distant object. See if you can see the details clearly. Step 3. Repeat with the other eye. Cover the other eye and repeat the process. Compare the clarity of vision between the two eyes and note your observations. If you or your children can't see the object clearly with one or both eyes, this could be a sign of myopia. But remember, this is just a preliminary test. For an accurate diagnosis, it's always best to consult with an eye care professional. Now, let's talk about the consequences of myopia. Why do we need to try to avoid it as much as possible? Myopia can have a significant impact on people's lives, both in the short and long term. In the short term, it can lead to impaired school performance. Children with myopia may have difficulty seeing the blackboard in the classroom, which hinders their understanding of subjects and participation in school activities. It can also cause visual fatigue. Straining to see distant objects can cause tiredness and headaches, affecting concentration and learning ability. There are warning signs to watch out for: frequent eye rubbing, excessive blinking, getting too close to books or screens, constantly squinting to see, and complaints like headaches and visual fatigue can be clues. Another problem is compromised daily activities. Blurred vision can interfere with sports, where clear and quick vision is essential. Imagine someone passes you the ball in football, but you only see it clearly when it's already close to you. Children with myopia may be more susceptible to accidents due to difficulty in clearly seeing distant objects and obstacles. In the long term, without proper care, myopia can progress, potentially leading to more serious eye health issues in the future. That's why it's crucial to take preventive measures and adopt healthy eye habits early on. So how can we protect our eyes and those of our children naturally? What are the tips for preventing myopia? Tip number 1. Increase outdoor time. Exposure to natural light is crucial for preventing myopia, as we've discussed. Encourage children to spend at least 2 hours outdoors every day. Activities like walking, playing ball, or cycling are excellent for this. Did you know that in countries like Taiwan, programs that encourage outdoor activities in schools have resulted in a significant reduction in myopia rates among children? Here in the U.S., we could adopt similar practices. What do you think? Tip number 2, reduce screen time. Limit the use of devices like cell phones, tablets, and computers. For children under 2 years old, the recommendation is to avoid screens entirely. For children between 2 and 5 years old, limit it to 1 hour per day. And for children 6 years and older, a maximum of 2 hours per day with regular breaks. Children should take breaks during the use of electronic devices. The rule is 20-20-20. Every 20 minutes of screen use, look at something 20 feet away for at least 20 seconds. Tip number 3, adopt healthy reading habits. Teach children to maintain an adequate distance when reading books or using devices like tablets or phones. Reading should be done at a distance of at least 12, 16 inches, 30 to 40 centimeters from the eyes. Make sure the lighting in the area is adequate to avoid more eye strain. Avoid reading in dark environments with poor lighting. Tip number 4, monitor and evaluate. Pay attention to any signs of vision problems in yourself and your children, even if there are no apparent symptoms. Early detection of myopia can help in managing the condition more effectively. Tip number 5, nutrition for eye health. A balanced diet rich in vitamins A, C, E, and omega-3 fatty acids can contribute to overall eye health. Foods like carrots, sweet potatoes, leafy greens, fish, and nuts are excellent choices. Consider incorporating these into your family's diet to support eye health naturally. Tip number 6, eye exercises. Simple eye exercises can help reduce eye strain and potentially slow the progression of myopia. Try the figure 8 exercise. Imagine a giant figure 8 about 10 feet in front of you. Trace the figure with your eyes slowly for about 30 seconds, then reverse direction. Tip 7, use of natural light. When indoors, try to work or read in areas with plenty of natural light. Position desks or reading areas near windows to maximize exposure to natural light during indoor activities. Tip 8. Practice the palm method. This is a relaxation technique for the eyes. Rub your palms together to warm them up, then gently place them over your closed eyes for about 30 seconds. The warmth and darkness can help relax eye muscles. Adopting these natural measures can make a big difference in preventing myopia and promoting eye health. Our modern lifestyle, with long hours indoors and constant exposure to screens, is worsening the situation. Have you thought about how many hours a day you spend looking at a screen? Yesterday, we were reading about this. A person looks at screens more than they will look at any person in their life. How about taking a break and going for a walk? Myopia is not just an inconvenience. It can lead to vision challenges in the future. We need to protect our eyes and those of our children naturally. And if you spend a lot of time in front of screens, how about calling your friends or family? Look them in the eye. We think they'll appreciate it. Did you like the video? Please like, share, and subscribe to the channel for more natural health tips like this. Remember to subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you in the next video. Thank you very much.